Manish.
Okay, thank you, sir. Good evening, everyone. We are pursuing Masters of Engineering degree from Gujarat Technological University, Ahmedabad. Currently, we are doing dissertation research in HCDC group at CDEC Pune under the guidance of Dr. Dinesh Katre. Now, in this presentation, we want to talk about the role of digital forensics in digital preservation to capture various digital evidences as per the Indian legal requirements for long-term preservation of emails, storage media, and mobile phones. Now, in quick overview, I want to tell about the Indian legal requirements in context of long-term preservation of electronic records and digital evidence. The IT Act 2000 and 2008 highlights the specific needs to retain the electronic records, and it also requires that the electronic record is retained in the format in which it was originally generated or in a format which can represent that electronic record accurately. It also defines the conditions for legal admissibility of electronic records. Therefore, it is necessary to capture various digital evidences and preserve it along with the electronic records that are required to be retained for long durations. Now, RTI Act talks about the reproducibility of electronic records. Now, as per the DPC Technology Watch report on digital forensics for digital preservation, digital forensic is an important part of digital curation process and digital archaeology. In India, digital forensic is being increasingly used for investigation of cyber crimes, but its applications for digital preservation is a new concept. We have also tested a tool called the BitCurator, which is a system for digital preservation communities that incorporates the functionalities of many digital forensic methods and tools into the workflows of a variety of collecting institutions. So by taking a reference of it, we have taken three different case scenarios, namely digital forensic for email preservation, for storage media preservation, and for mobile data preservation. Now, our purpose is to find legal evidences and metadata and all acceptable information that can be mapped with the preservation metadata of the OIS for long-term preservation of email storage media and cell phones. Now, OIS is an ISO standard of a reference model for digital archive, and as per the OIS, there are two kinds of information, content information and preservation description information, which is preservation metadata. In our case, content information is the electronic records, such as emails or storage media and cell phones. There are four types of preservation metadata, provenance, fixity, authenticity, and reliability. Provenance metadata documents the history of content information and its chain of custody, including its origin and changes to the object or its content over time. Fixity metadata provides the data integrity checks to ensure that the particular content object has not been altered in an undocumented manner. And authenticity and reliability helps to make sure that the electronic record is authentic and reliable. Now, our approach is apply open source digital forensic tools on the sample device and data to capture various digital evidences and analyze and corroborate those digital evidences to establish the aspects of digital preservation in terms of provenance, integrity, authenticity, and reliability. Now, email preservation. Emails are very important in business and government organizations. Email conversations are required to preserve to fulfill a right to information. Further, Department of Electronics and Information Technology, Government of India, is already formulating the email policy for all government organizations in India for the purpose of email data protection, which will also be subjected to preservation in various cases. Unlike any other born digital documents, emails are very different and dynamic in nature. The emails consist of two major parts, body part and header part. Body part is the main content of the email, and the header part is generally hidden and contains extra information in key value pair format defined in RFC 4021. Now, important evidence to establish origin, destination, date and time of dispatch and receipt of an email are found in the header part. Some common header fields visible to users are from, to, date and subject. Now, this is an example of email header. There are lots of information available in the header part of the email, but not all the evidences are useful for establishing the digital provenance, authenticity, integrity, and reliability. What we did was to identify all the available information and to map those information with legal requirements and put in the form of in the form which OIS requires. Here, red box highlights the mandatory header fields which are useful for inferential authenticity. Now, if an email is considered as a record, it must have a unique identifier number by which a specific email could be identified. Now, the message ID field gives globally unique message identifier generated by sending SMTP server, which can be used as a record identifier in preservation system. So, when you are referring or replying an email, it could be identified by a message ID value. Here the red box highlights the reference message ID, meaning that this email was in response of the previous email identified by this ID. This is the most important evidence in header of the email, which is trace information. When SMTP server or mail transfer agent accepts or forwards an email, it inserts trace information in the form of received field, which is used in tracing the email back to the sender. This field includes name or IP address of the MTA for which mail was received, and name of the receiving MTA, protocol used in transfer, and the timestamp of transaction. User agent field along with received fields are very important digital provenance information. Now, authenticity and integrity. The purpose and the meaning of email authentication here is to validate the identities of the parties who participated in creating and transferring message. And the integrity is to verify that the message content is not altered in transit. Authentication of sending domain could be performed with DKIM signature, which is domain key identified mail. A signature is a method for associating a domain with an email message. The association is set up by means of digital signature, which can be validated at the server level. It is possible to digitally sign the outgoing messages, which authenticates and identify of the sender and validates the integrity at the user level. Content MD5 header is MD5 checksum of the content, helps in checking the integrity of the email body data. Now, to preserve an email, you must have an email message in some object form. Different email clients create different types of email message objects. Some of them are listed in this table. According to OIS requirements, the preservation object must be in standard format, and most importantly, it should be in non-proprietary format. For example, a PST object file, which is Microsoft Outlook Personal Storage Table, it is proprietary format controlled by Microsoft and cannot be used for long-term preservation of email. After going through number of file formats, we have identified EML for single email preservation. It is ASCII text file and having open specification, and it is useful for email preservation. Now, mbox can be used for email account preservation. All the emails from single account are stored in one mbox file with attachments in base64 format. XML is suitable for email preservation, which allows self-description. However, preservation of attachments cannot be guaranteed unless it is open and standard format. Now, storage media preservation. Digital repositories often receive miscellaneous electronics of record or unorganized data from organization for preservation purpose, which is deposited in the form of a digital storage media like hard disk, USB drives, or CD or DVDs. For example, National Archives of India someday receives the hard disk or pen drive from a government organization for long-term preservation. In such cases, it is not possible to ingest the electronic records or data individually in an open archival information system, considering the unstructured or unorganized or miscellaneous nature of the data stored in the disk. In such situation, it is often considered to capture the disk image of the storage media and then ingested into the open archival system. Forensic disk image is an exact replica of the source media, which contains any slack space, unallocated space, and other metadata of the disk volume. Therefore, we can say that it is reliable. Here, it should be noted that before taking bitstream images using any tool, care should be taken that the device is write protected to prohibit any changes. Now, these are the various preservation metadata of the disk image. The serial number of the disk image or of the storage media is extremely useful for proving the source of the disk image, which is captured in the metadata. Fixed size hash value derived from original disk image using irreversible hashing algorithm like MD5, SHA-1 or SHA-256 can be used to establish the integrity of the content. Then chain of custody information, such as cache number allocated to digital evidence, the list of tools used for collecting digital evidences, examiner name, short description of the digital evidence, the path where the digital evidence is stored initially, and the time of acquisition of digital evidence or disk image, which contains MACB times, which is modified access, created, and birth time of the disk image, are extremely useful for proving the digital provenance of disk image. Now, there are various types of disk image formats available, but we have mainly focused on raw formats and advanced forensic format, and the comparison between these two formats is listed in this table. Both the formats are open and bit-by-bit copy of the original source media, but advanced forensic format is extensible and it includes metadata along with the disk image, and it also supports compression algorithm, so we have chosen AFF format for disk image to be captured. And these are the various open source forensic disk imaging tools available. This is the screenshot of the disk image metadata captured in AFF format using a tool GuyMager, which is an open source and it supports both RAW and AFF format. Here, red box describes the MD5 hash value of the disk image, which establishes the integrity of the content, and black box is the chain of custody information for digital provenance. And the green box highlights the serial number of the device, which proves the source of the disk image. Now, cell phones are essential elements of today's life, especially smartphones. Those are equipped with more resources in terms of processing power, storage capacity, and memory. With advancement in these technologies and network access, they are becoming prone to misuse. Now consider a crime scene where a cell phone device is found as an important evidence. Now in India, court case runs for 10 to 15 years long period, so the device needs to be kept under police custody for this much period of time. In such cases, there is a possibility that the device becomes obsolete and it is not accessible, or it may not find a battery or charger or cable that fits into that device. Therefore, for legal admissibility, it needs to be preserved for a long time, and it is necessary to find the digital evidences from these devices and preserve it as per the reference model. Now, to capture digital evidences, we have used mobile forensic procedures. We have captured raw image of the cell phone memory, which we treated as the content information, and this process is called physical acquisition. Physical acquisition performs bit-by-bit copy of a cell phone memory and produces exact replica or memory dump in raw format. Another method is logical acquisition, which captures the preservation metadata of the cell phone. Now, these are the various preservation metadata of the cell phone. Timestamp, unique identifier numbers, and software and hardware information, and product details, which are useful to prove the digital provenance. And for establishing integrity, as per the previous cases, MD5 or SHA algorithms can be used. Cell phone also contains information such as call logs, SMS logs and contacts information. So by corroborating this information with service provider, we can establish the inferential authenticity. And capturing this data from multiple sources, we can establish the reliability. Now, there are different cell phone forensic tools available, but we have used the AF Logical OIC, which is open source, and it captures the hardware and software information of the mobile device. And VIA Forensic VIA Extract tool, which is used for metadata capturing, which is freeware and available for demo. Now this is the screenshot of the output of a tool, AF Logical OIC, which captures the hardware and software information which are going to be used for proving digital provenance. It includes all the preservation metadata information that I have discussed before. And this is the screen. This screenshot displays the output of VIA Extract tool, which includes the browsing bookmarks, and this includes the browsing history information. Now in summary, this is the list of digital forensic tools that we have used in these three case scenarios. And in conclusion, here is the outcome of these three case studies, which list the aspects of digital preservation and the metadata which can be derived using digital forensic technologies and can be mapped with the preservation metadata of Open Archival Information System for long-term preservation of emails, storage media, and Android cell phone data. Now in future directions, we can build a software solution that is the pre-ingest process of OIS for preserving email, storage media, and cell phone data for long-term. This will capture the metadata from emails or storage media or cell phones and maps those metadata with the preservation metadata, and it also it will identify the format of the data in terms of proprietary or non-proprietary format or preservation or non-preservation format, and finally it will generate submission information packages that can be ingested into the as per the Open Archival Information System. Thank you.